And petitions with hundreds of thousands of names were delivered today to the Georgia Pardons Board in Atlanta on behalf of a death row inmate. The petitions gathered by Amnesty International, the NAACP, and other groups seek clemency for Troy Davis. He is scheduled to be executed next Wednesday at 7 p.m. Davis was sentenced to die for the 1989 murder of an off-duty police officer in Savannah, Georgia. He's also insisted he's innocent, and there are a lot of disturbing new questions that have been raised in regards to his case. Joining me now via Skype from thegrio.com, columnist Goldie Taylor. Goldie, thanks for the time here. You've got an intriguing story here, and quite honestly, the family members of the officer who was murdered feel that the right man will die if Troy Davis is put to death on Wednesday. But his attorneys say, listen, you've got evidence that's changed this case. Where are we now?
I think today, you know, this case has been a cause celebre since, I guess, probably the early 90s here in Georgia. The family has always said that Troy Davis is the man who killed Officer McPhail. They've never moved away from that. But to counter that, Troy Davis has always, always said that he was innocent. It is worthy to note that nearly every prosecution witness, down to just one, has recanted their testimony. There is a man walking free in Georgia who has admitted that he killed Officer McPhail, admitted to several people. Troy Davis at one point had been given a new trial ordered by the Supreme Court, but that trial never happened because a judge, an appeals judge here in Georgia, decided that there just wasn't enough evidence. And so this case, you know, barring an act of God, you know, before next week, Troy Davis will be executed after 4 stages of execution over the last 4 years.
And what's intriguing is that judge that you mentioned also said that it was, I guess, the onus was on Troy Davis and his attorneys to prove his innocence, which obviously is the complete counter of what we know about our justice system. The burden of proof is not on the person who's been accused, it's on the prosecution. And you've got legal experts from around the world who say that there are holes in the prosecution's case that it may not say this man is innocent, but it certainly brings up the doubt which should save his life.
Now, I'm no lawyer, but that judge got it exactly wrong. And I'm backed up people like former FBI Director Bill Sessions or former Congressman Bob Barr, people conservatives. Former President George W. Bush is on Troy Davis's side, as well as former President Jimmy Carter. That judge got it exactly wrong. He said in his written statement that he saw doubt in this case. That is enough. That is enough to stop an execution for me, and it should be for that judge.
Well, to your point, the Republicans, Democrats, people described as liberals and conservatives have all come together in this case. We will see what happens. We're going to have more on this as so many other people have been following this, and keep our audience up to date. Thank you very much, Goldie. It's great seeing you.